The Shazo back to throw in the pocket, throwing it deep. He has a man down there. White has it. Touchdown Tech. Play to the left side to Shazo. A late pitch to Thomas. Turns the corner to the 30. Breaks ahead of the 40. A wonderful spin move. Breaks free at the 50. Dwayne Thomas turns on the Jets. Right into the end zone. He's going to take it all the way. A magnificent run by Dwayne Thomas, who did a 360 spin. And he took it all the way for the touchdown.
These three words mean you're getting busy. Whoop, that is Hitman. Now it's time for it to get on the mic and make this motherfucking party hype. I'm taking it back to the old school, cause I'm an old fool who's so cool. If you wanna get down, I'ma show you the way. Ooh, yeah, it is. Let me hear you say,
ooh.
Saka, 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 saka
still going to the 50. Thomas breaks it. There he goes in open field to the 30. Dwayne Thomas is going to take this baby all the way. Touchdown, Tech.
Sun beat down. I hit the radio wall. I was driving. Trees went by. Me and Dell were singing.
And DeShazo takes the snap. Fakes the toss sweep. Back to throw. Fires it deep down the left side. Looking for Freeman. Has it in stride. It is another magnificent touchdown from Maurice DeShazo to Antonio Freeman.
Like anything was possible, hit cruise control and rub my eyes. The last 3 days, and the rain was unstoppable. It was always cold, no sunshine. Yeah, running down a drain, they never would come to me. Working on a mystery.
Sidelines caught by Freeman of Tech across the 50. Antonio going to the 40. Leaps over a man. He's down to the 20. Still going at the 10. Freeman takes it all the way.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them blue. For me and you, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
Their 6'4 quarterback barks out the signals as the center Rod Carey gets over the ball. A low snap. Pacey picks it up off the grass. In trouble though, and he'll be sacked inside the 10-yard line. DeShazo back to throw. The Indiana team blitzes. Tech dumps it off on the near sideline. It's caught by Thomas at the 10. Blockers in front of him. He will take it in. Touchdown, Tech! It's up for grabs, and this ball is intercepted by Tech.
Have hammered the Indiana Hoosiers here today by the final score of 45-20. Tech setting a new Independence Bowl record for the most points ever scored in this game.
battered hands are all you own. This broken heart is turned to stone. Go hang your glory on the wall. There comes a time when castles fall. And all that's left is shifting in the sand. You're out of time, you're out of place. Look at your face, that's the measure of a man. This coat that fits you like a glove, these dirty streets you learn to love. So welcome back, my long-lost friend. You've been to hell and back again. And God alone knows how you crossed that span. Back on the beat, back to the start. Trust in your heart, that's the measure of a man. Circle, now you're home. Without the gold, without the crown. This is where you've always been. You had to lose so you could win. Rise above your troubles while you can. Now you can love, now you can lose, now you can choose. That's the measure of a man.
The march to the Independence Bowl began in Blacksburg, where Virginia Tech opened the 1993 season against Bowling Green. Frank Beamer and his Hokies looking to start the year on the right foot. Both feet working well for sophomore Dwayne Thomas as Virginia Tech unveils its balanced attack. Dwayne Thomas on the ground and junior Maurice DeShazo through the air. DeShazo to his big play man Antonio Freeman, 46 yards for the score to break the game open. On the other side of the ball, the Virginia Tech defense held Bowling Green to just 45 yards rushing. The Hokies debut with the win, handling the Falcons 33-16, the final. Next for Virginia Tech, a road trip north for a Big East meeting with Johnny Majors and the Pitt Panthers. How would the young Hokies respond on the road? Well, just fine. Pitt could generate nothing against the stingy Virginia Tech defense, while the Hokies' offense was unstoppable. Dewayne Thomas would lead Virginia Tech in rushing for the second straight week. The sophomore out of Florida had 170 yards on the ground. Also standing out in the Virginia Tech backfield, Tommy Edwards, the freshman out of Radford, Virginia. What a beautiful 55-yard catch and run. Edwards shows why he's called Touchdown Tommy. He would score four touchdowns on the evening against the Pitt Panthers, and that gave him six touchdowns in two games. And at the time, Tommy Edwards was the nation's leading scorer. Virginia Tech rushed for 500 yards while giving up just 150 on the ground. The Hokies opened some eyes as they dot Pittsburgh. 63-21, Virginia Tech improves to a perfect 2-0. However, things get a bit tougher in Miami. The Hurricanes ranked number three in the nation, seeking their 52nd straight win at the Orange Bowl. Nonetheless, Virginia Tech brought the heat. The Hokies stayed in Miami's face all afternoon, recording five sacks and holding the Canes to just 54 yards on the ground. It was a 7-0 game at the half, but Tech's high-powered offense sputtered, and Virginia Tech drops its first game of the year. Miami wins it 21-2. But the Hokies bounce right back. After two on the road, it was back to Blacksburg, just what the doctor ordered, and they took it out on the Maryland Terrapins. Virginia Tech opened up the offense, scoring 35 points in the first half. DeShazo to Freeman would work twice, one for 20 yards and a score, the other for 57 and a touchdown. Tech made it miserable for the Terps quarterback Scott Milanovich, J.C. Price with the sack, and then Dewayne Knight. Dewayne Knight keeps him out of the end zone, and then Knight lowers the boom on what was one of ESPN's hits of the year. After being shut out the week before, the Hokie offense rolls. Virginia Tech wins it 55-28, improving to 3-1. The most heartbreaking game of the year came on the road at West Virginia. The Hokies led most of the contest, taking the advantage on touchdown passes to Steve Sanders and Cornelius White. The Tech defense kept the ears off the scoreboard until late in the third quarter. The Hokies, however, never established the ground attack. The national-ranked Tech rushing crew was held to a total of 130 yards. It was a true dogfight between two rivals, and the Hokies had a chance. An attempt by Ryan Williams that would have won it sailed right. The win propelled West Virginia to one of its greatest seasons. The defeat motivated the Hokies. They knew they let one get away. Virginia Tech started the second half of the season at home against Temple. The Hokies' offense was warm during the first five games, but absolutely caught fire down the stretch. Against the Owls, DeShazo and company would post 552 yards of total offense. Dewayne Thomas brought the Tech faithful to their feet with a 73-yarder. He finished with 152 yards on the ground and two touchdowns. DeShazo was hot. He threw for 325 yards, also four touchdowns through the air. Tech's defense only let the Owls in the end zone once. The Hokies moved to 4-2 with the 55-7 rout of Temple. For the second straight year, Tech and Rutgers hooked up in a Big East scoring duel. In the first half, the Hokie defense was dominant, allowing just one touchdown. But Virginia Tech knew to beat Rutgers, they'd need points, and points they got. Maurice DeShazo threw three touchdowns on the afternoon, and Tech got production on the ground. Still, this one went to the wire. However, this time, the Hokies hold on and win it 49-42. Virginia Tech looked to lock down a winning season when the Hokies lined up on a wet, soggy day with East Carolina. This one was decided in the second half. Close at the break, the final two quarters, however, Virginia Tech's defense would hold the Pirates to just 68 yards of offense. Virginia Tech won this one on the ground. The Hokies outrushed East Carolina 238 yards to 86. Virginia Tech scored 17 second-half points while giving up zero to the Pirates. The Hokies improved to 6-2, pushing the Pirates aside 31-12 the final. Tech's three-game winning streak came to an end at Boston College. The Hokies ran into a red-hot quarterback in Glenn Foley. BC took a 28-7 lead, but Virginia Tech didn't quit. The Hokies battled back to make it a 34-27 game, but that's when they ran out of steam. Tech suffers a setback in Game 9, losing to Boston College, the final 48-34. However, the Hokies regroup, and they went after Syracuse. Talk about character. After every loss in 1993, Virginia Tech responded, bounced back the next game with the win. The Orangemen never knew what hit them. Maurice DeShazo and his offense jumped out to a quick 24-0 lead. Syracuse attempted a rally, but the Tech defense would have none of that. Tech improves to 7-3 overall with the 45-24 win. And after the ball game, the Hokies accept a bid to the Independence Bowl, their first bid since 1986. A time to celebrate. However, one game remained. Not just any game. Next for the Hokies, state rival UVA. The Hokies closed out the regular season with a total team effort. Nothing would put a sweeter finish to this turnaround year than to beat Virginia in Charlottesville. Special teams came up with the first big play of the game. Freshman Brandon Simonis blocks the punt. That would set up a Ryan Williams 30-yarder, and the Hokies draw first blood to take a 3-0 lead. Next to contribute, the offense in the second quarter. With the game tied 3-3, it's straight ahead for Dwayne Thomas, and Virginia Tech takes a 10-3 advantage. Then it was the defense's turn to make something happen. Simeon Willis back to pass for Virginia, and here come the Hokies. Cornell Brown knocks it loose, and big Jeff Holland is there to sweep up the loose ball at the three and take it in for the touchdown. Virginia Tech would lead at the half 17-10. In the second half, Virginia Tech's defense sealed the ball game. Virginia had a first down at the Hokie 12-yard line, but failed to score. Tech would keep UVA out of the end zone the entire second half. Defense does the job as Virginia Tech wins it 20-17, finishing the regular season at 8-3. The Hokies also finished ranked 20th in the CNN USA Today coaches poll and 22nd by the Associated Press.
Coach Frank Beamer and the Hokies getting it going early. Tech led 14-13 with less than a minute and a half when they break it wide open. They hit quarterback John Casey, who fumbles the ball. J.C. Price tries to pick it up, and he kicks it. A nice bounce for Lawrence Lewis, who takes it the rest of the way. Tech jumping out to a 21-13 lead. Then with 1 second left in the half, Indiana tries a field goal, but it's blocked. Antonio Banks is there. Goes one way, too many Indiana guys. Go the other way, Antonio. Get some blockers, and Antonio Banks takes it 81 yards. Watch this nice block coming up right there as Antonio. 81 yards for the touchdown. Tech leads 28-13 at the break. Second half, the Hokies just break it wide open. Maurice DeShazo rolls to his left, finds the big play receiver Antonio Freeman, who tiptoes down the sideline in there for the touchdown. They blow out Indiana 45-20. Virginia Tech finishing the year at 9-3.